two magnitude greater than 6 earthquakes occurred in the Healy region of interior Alaska in January and July of 1929. As the paper wrote here, a series of earthquakes whose violence has not been equaled since the summer of 1912 when Mount Katmai erupted gave Fairbanks the worst shaking up in its history early this morning. At no time since the city was founded have shocks of such duration and intensity been felt, the tremors of 1912 having lasted for much briefer periods. The first thing that's most interesting to me is that 17 years have elapsed between 1912 and 1929, and yet that information is still valuable and recalled here. It shows the value of oral history in these observations, both scientifically and in a way of transmitting history from one generation to the next. As the title notes, there was minimal damage from the 1929 earthquakes. The annual U.S. compilation of earthquakes wrote this of the earthquake effects in Fairbanks. Many of the houses are one story and built of logs, specifically developed for the winter conditions and are especially suited to resist earthquakes. Broken windows and displaced articles are about the extent of the damage. In fact, it was only 3 years earlier that the first non-wood building in Fairbanks had been built. Fairbanks was growing in population, and along with it came structures prone to damage. In the local news we read, the Fairbanks High School basketball quintet won the second straight game from Anchorage High School Saturday night. John Butrovich again led the local high school's offensive, making a total of 21 points. Butrovich, as we'll see later, is featured selling earthquake insurance in 1937, and becomes the namesake of the statewide University of Alaska building, which sits opposite from us here at the museum. The railroad bridge in Nenana is 6 years old, and trains can now bring heavy goods into the interior. Steamships on the river are still the main source of travel. The front page on January 21st includes the headline, "Postmaster to Urge Air Mail for Territory," in addition to a story about a train out of Fairbanks connecting Seward with the steamship bound for Seattle. The era of river dominance is coming to a close.